Passenger trains take people from one place to another. In the United States, Amtrak runs most passenger trains. Some trains have special cars where they have special events. This train is called the Coast Starlight, and it has wine tasting in the afternoon. Passengers get to sample wines from Washington, Oregon, and California. Passenger trains stop at train stations to let passengers off and to welcome new passengers. Train stations are also called depots. A train called the Coast Starlight stops at Portland, Oregon, where this water park helps people cool off near the Willamette River. If you saw part one of Passenger Trains, you might remember the name of this car. It's called the Parlor Car, and it's only on the Coast Starlight. The Coast Starlight is a long-distance train, traveling from Seattle, Washington to Los Angeles each day, a trip that lasts 2 days on the rails. At times, the Coast Starlight runs right on the edge of the Pacific Ocean, with nothing between the train and the beach. This unforgettable sight, a gray whale breaching in the ocean, was seen from the Coast Starlight.
I thought that was a tail at first.
Sometimes the most exciting sight is the train itself.
There's no wall in your way to see.
The Coast Starlight terminates at Union Station in Los Angeles. If you were boarding the Coast Starlight to go north, you would enter here. If you didn't already have a ticket, this is where you could buy one. If you already had a ticket, this is where you would wait for your train to board. Los Angeles Union Station also serves the Sunset Limited to New Orleans and the Southwest Chief to Chicago, and several regional and local trains as well. This huge historic building was constructed in the early 1900s, when most long-distance travel was by train. These ticket windows were very busy back then. Today they're preserved as history when private railroads carried passengers. This area is called a platform. Here we see passengers from the Southwest Chief to training at Los Angeles Union Station. Some of these people have been on this train since Chicago, 2 days earlier. Here we see train crew members waiting to board their train. This sign gives information about the northbound Coast Starlight, Train 14. This is a sleeping car. Passengers here wait for their train to pull out of the station.
And you can get specialty coffees.
Now the northbound train has left the station and is moving north towards Seattle. Many small towns along the tracks have stations. This is the station at Klamath Falls. The train changes engineers and conductors here. Here, some passengers board the train, and soon the Coast Starlight pulls out of the station. Passenger stations can be busy places when trains are arriving or leaving.
As you leave the station, please look around, make sure you have all of your personal belongings.
Most stations announce the arrival of trains ahead of time so passengers can get ready. In most small stations, the platform is located outside where passengers wait for their train. Be sure you get on the train on time, or it'll leave without you. In part one of this program, we listed some of the cars you find on passenger trains. On some long-distance trains, there's even a movie theater in one of the cars. Now let's look at some of the people who work on passenger trains. This is one of the waiters in the dining car. There's also a cook who works in the kitchen. Here's a car attendant. He helps passengers enjoy their trip.
Car attendant. And what's your name?
My name is Anthony.
Anthony, nice to meet you.
Notice the hats that these crew members wear. These are conductors. They're in charge of the train.
Folks, you need to talk to me right here.
Conductors collect tickets and help passengers find their seats. They also remove unruly passengers from the train. And the engineer drives the train. Day and night, Amtrak moves passengers across the region or across the country, giving them the best view possible of the United States of America.